Sir Unknown, and says they plan to Israel, Elal plan to lead to Israel to come midday, Friday. But because of the snow, the heavy snow, you know, and cars, planes could not move because of, you know, the streets and pathways. So they were delayed. So quite few went to Israel. So came down, landed in Europe. So the Orthodox Jews will be before Shabbat. But one of the flights from New York to Tel Aviv was delayed for a few hours. The only time it could come to Tel Aviv was Friday night, which is Sabbath. So therefore, the Orthodox Jews, 70 of them, really came down on Athens and then started the Nazir. But stories fell in the papers, the other Jews did not behave, they behaved wildly, the people, and in fact it was found that it was completely a lie, fake news. Now the story is the following, what you see here. Fake news about the Orthodox Jews who were in the in a large plane that was delayed for a long time because of the snow, and as we said, the whole story. So it happened that in the plane was a reporter, not from a from religious paper. His name is Yair Schlesinger, a reporter for newspaper Israel Hayom, not a religious one, who was on the plane, said that it was not true what was advertised in Israeli papers, that the Orthodox Jews behaved wildly. The truth is that the behavior of the Orthodox was extremely nice, and that which was advertised in the paper against them was a lie and pure incitement. Now, incitement against Orthodox is very popular in Israel. You know, there are parties, you know, that they want Jews to vote for them, and how could they vote for such Orthodox religious party will behave like this. So definitely this is an incitement which goes more and more. And in fact, our rabbis tell us in the Talmud, the Gemara, Sanhedrin, it is a part of the Gemara which is called Chelek, the chapter Chelek, and there, 1988, you have clear description about the situation in Israel before the coming Messiah will be ruled by not religious people, and will be a lot of things against religious, whatever it is, exactly what is happening, unfolding this kind of incitement, clear sign that we are nearing the Messiah. Now, let us see what the Torah, the blueprint of creation, tells us about this. So this is what I looked for. Wave, in fact, in Israel, they call it like a wave of incitement, you know, now. It's apparently will be elections, so no, so there is a anti-religious movements will come very strongly against the religious, so because they wanted to vote for religious parties. But this is really comes, so I looked for best meeting of Gal wave of incitement, and definitely against what the incitement is. So it came out, by the way, it is in one book, Deuteronomy, the fifth book, which is against our millennium, it's a Vilna Gaon Street. So you have your Gal HaSata, minimal religious book, and then next to it you can see against what? Here is a negative, you know this, so. But the idea that comes exactly the incitement is against Judaism, in Hebrew Yadut, which is what comes here, then against the Torah, in Torah, the law of God, and everything, and then against Datiim. Datiim are those who keep the religion, religious people, amazing. Now, this is exactly what is going on. Here you have the forces which are against. It is known that the leftists, because the leftists in Israel are those parties like Meretz, and even the other one, the Labour Party in Israel also, against the allowed transport on Shabbat, and also against the Torah. Yeah? So all this comes, and they have to do the left. Here is the Hebrew word, small left. And here you have the evil forces, which is Samael, very close to the verse left, because the sin and the Samael are changeable. And this is really the heavenly minister of Amalek, which is against the Torah, against God. In fact, our rabbi says the name of the angel, Samael, means Samakel. Sama, blinding God, means doesn't allow that the divine providence will be shown in this world. So, and then, perhaps the most important thing is what our rabbi said, that before the coming of the Messiah, the Zohar are full of it. It will be ruled, reigned by unreligious people, and even leaders will be against the Torah, against God. And this they call Erev Rav, mixed multitude, very famous. Anybody who knows a little bit of Judaism, of, even the Medrash Kabbalah, there is an idea, Erev Rav, mixed multitude in Israel. You can see in Israel here, the word Israel, unfortunately, against the Torah. And coming it in a parallel way, it was significant. You know, you cannot put a thing as you want it to come. Then I thought, no, let us see if the Messiah is here, because you say it's clear. There's this kind of phenomena, this wave of incitement against religious, Orthodox is a part of the mixtures, the son of Messiah, so I put Mashiach Hashem. Okay, so, but I want to know, but still, how he will come in such a situation? He will come, because Jews will have to do tshuva, to repent. Repent is a very small scale. Why? Because apparently Jews slowly will understand that all these leftists and all these are really mainly what they are doing against Israel, against Netanyahu, against, but some pure, nice values, nothing. So, interesting table, and showing that we are very near to the time of Messiah, so the only thing we have to do is Shiva, to do repentance, which can be a very small skill.